At this point in the course, you may be asking yourself about shopping. How can you order from Amazon privately and securely? What about physical stores? This is tricky because it's difficult to do. Let's go ahead and cover different techniques and methods we can use to make our shopping experiences online and in-store safer. Keep in mind, this is a more extreme lesson, so those of you who draw your convenience lines early may find this lesson out of your zone. Hello there, and thanks for watching Go Incognito. This course is entirely free, and one of the ways we can do that is through our many supporters who believe in our mission in spreading privacy and security to the masses. If you enjoy our work and want to help our cause, we have perks for supporters on Patreon and YouTube, and we recently introduced one-time donations through Ko-fi and PayPal. The latter needs no account on your end. We also accept Monero for those wanting to donate with the utmost privacy in mind. Thank you to all our current supporters, thanks to all of our future supporters, and thank you for watching the free course. Enjoy the rest of the lesson. Let's start with in-person stores, leaving the digital side out of the equation. Security-wise, we need to be careful. We don't know how stores handle your data. Target has been hacked, Home Depot, Wendy's, Chipotle, Whole Foods, Sonic, Under Armour, Panera Bread, Sears, and there are many more, and the list is just gonna keep going on. The best way to secure your information is by not giving your information. Here's how to do it. 1. Pay with cash as much as possible. Neither the store or your bank can collect any data on your shopping habits. 2. If a store doesn't take cash, you can use prepaid debit cards without your information. Purchase a non-relatable prepaid Visa gift card, like the vanilla Visa, and use falsified information if needed. The idea is to purchase these with cash, but if your threat model isn't as high, you can use your card to buy them. Watch out for reloadable cards, since they require your real name, address, birth dates, and social security number to use. Keep in mind, even when you buy prepaid cards, there will be video cameras and other methods of tracking you within the store, not to mention your trip to the store is tracked as well, so you'll need a private method of transportation, assuming your threat model is this extreme. A side note for EU viewers, the website viabuy.com can get you a credit card without credit checks or links to your bank account. Speaking of credit, credit bureaus are widely known to share and sell user data, which is why you may receive offers for other credit cards in the mail. You can opt out of this by visiting this website and opt out. 3. If you don't want to or can't use cash or prepaid debit cards in a store and you're set on paying with your personal debit or credit card, at least implement basic security measures. Contact your bank to increase the length of your PIN to at least 6 digits, preferably 8. Don't sign the back of your card, write ask for photo ID, and consider investing in an RFID blocking wallet or purse to protect your information from RFID attacks. 4. Avoid signing up for rewards programs and credit cards. If you do want to open a rewards account, you don't normally need to provide your real information. Wink wink, pseudonyms, we just talked about them in the last lesson. 5. And the final step, go into every store with a pseudo. You never know when people will ask for information, and if you're not prepared, you're going to give your real information. Be prepared, like Japeth. That wraps up physical stores, but what about digital shopping? Stores are being hacked left and right, phishing attacks are never ending, and your personal information is constantly at risk. Let's just use a popular website as an example. Amazon requires an email and a name, both of which don't have to be genuine, just use a pseudonym. Remember to send packages to your pseudonym's private mailbox, or you could ship to an Amazon locker. Now, everything is private except payment. You have 3 options if you don't want the purchase tied to you. 1. The recommended payment option is to purchase an Amazon gift card at a local store with cash. You can continue reloading your Amazon account with gift cards indefinitely. The second option, if you insist on paying with a card, is seeing if your bank offers virtual expendable cards to protect your actual card. If this isn't possible, services like privacy.com offer similar functionality. But I would always recommend the gift card route. It is significantly more robust. 3. As we mentioned earlier, you can use prepaid non-relatable debit cards. Congrats! You are now using Amazon privately and securely with no personal information. Lucky for you, the rules are extremely similar on other sites with one main difference. Lots of sites don't even require an account to make a purchase. If you can check out as a guest, take that route. Rather than using Amazon gift cards though, just use prepaid debit cards and a pseudonym to make an account if one is even required. And that, my friends, is how to shop safely. It's important you take control of your data because the places you shop don't have your security and privacy on their priority list. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson, Lifestyle Changes.